pero el móvil móvil no. Yo era solo. Fui nada, yo oía el uno, no fue amo. Fue talitari ahí. Era solo. Se fue el uno ahí. Just want to thank everybody today. All of us today just being here. With your loving heart. Wanting to be part of this ceremony. Brother Nu, a friend to you, uncles, a father, grandfather. Let's give it all to the Lord. And it's all about God. Let's pray. Heavenly Father, it's only you, O God, can bring comfort in a house of mourning today. Express the children of our brother Lou, grandchildren, siblings, sisters and brothers, not only them, fathers and mothers. And all of us who are here today, our hearts cry out. But we know the ending of our life is death. We pray for the Holy Spirit to come in this place. Give us the understanding heart that we may go through this service today understanding death is where we come to you, O Lord. Bless this service today. Anoint this service today. Bless all your people who are here today, O God. Whatever language we are speaking, O Lord, related to us, that we can all benefit and understand as we go through this service, O Lord. Bless all the pastors and the ministers who are about to form and work the work that they call for, O Lord. The work of comfort. The work of encouragement. Of bringing your words forward. We ask you, Jesus, in your name. Amen and amen. Let's worship the Lord this morning. Praise the Lord. Fellowship with us today.
Maria, Maria, oh yeah.
the leader of the worship this morning.
Amen.
Sister Lee. To guide us into some songs and worship this morning. That we only the songs and the word of the song can bring meaning of the word of God in our heart. And by listening and singing and worship God, God will put peace in our heart, comfort our heart, and uplift our spirit up. He is alive. And He is looking down to us. And He is sitting on our worship this morning. Praise the Lord. We have a leader of a worship this morning. Sister Lay, Vasily, Joe, Ben, all those names. Praise the Lord.
It's a call to worship. It's a must that we must worship Him. Worship Him because God is looking for those who are worshiping Him in spirit and in truth. And with all what's going on up in heaven, amen, 24/7. And we must be excited, in joy, to worship the Master. Wherever you're coming from, wherever ethnicity you're from, wherever country, whatever language that you speak, but the God that we serve is the God, the one and only God. My worship to you. We worship in this way. In worship, it's a free will to do it.
Hallelujah. Glory, hallelujah.
You are the only one. Reading of the Old Testament, Pastor Yonatana Bena. Reading of the New Testament, Pastor Pam Bamu. After the Word of God, we'll go straight to the prayer of comfort. There will be Pastor James Sangamputere, travel all the way from Hawaii. Praise the Lord. Take your fight the wing of the film on it.
Far from my own, if I do not have your real poor, I would like to ask if we could stand as we read the Word of God. It's up to you. May we allow the Lord to speak to us this morning through His Word. For the perishable must clothe itself with the imperishable, and the mortal with immortality. When the perishable has been clothed with imperishable, and the mortal with immortality, then the saying that is written will come true. Death has been swallowed up in victory. Where, O death, is your victory? Where, O death, is your sting? The sting of death is sin, and the power of sin is the law. But thanks be to God, He gives us the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ. Therefore, my dear brothers, stand firm. Let nothing move you. Always give yourself fully to the work of the Lord, because you know that your labor is not in vain. Why the town on the offer in 18 on a bill? You're over 14 in 18 on Leo Tirama. They are over 14 in 18 on a bill. Are over 14 in 18 on Leo Tirama. On a town, no one I ever put what you see. We found a material Leoti in a man of man. Leoti. O fair o yai lo tuli. The took my man away. O fair o yai lo manu manu. O le tuli yeleoti, o le anasala lea. O le maa losi fo ile o le anasala, o le tula afono. Ae faa fetai ile atua. O le na te fua ina mai le manu manu, ya tato talu lo tato bolii, o Yesu Kristo. O le ne, o uso peile, ye auto to mau male fanga etia. Yan wanu lo auto fa malos. In an alwena lele, male lea no. In a ua auto ino. It is a mere fa lea mine and auto tautina ineri. May the Lord bless you on His word and may the Lord bless you. You may be seated. Thank you.
Prepare our hearts before we go in front of the throne of the Lord through prayer and prayer of comfort to the family. As I pray, Body of Christ, Let's pray together. Amen. Lo matuta male langi faftai lava I dinei tai au. Faftai le tua ua mafaina taitaina mai matuaina nei pole e kalesia o wera au fia foi o matu mafuta I dinei tai au. Faftai si tai au fo le tua ua matu maua. Father, we want to thank you for this beautiful day that you have given us. Father, we want to thank you for this beautiful day that you have given us. Father, we matu fa moalama, we matu roto e luma luothia. We humble ourselves, Lord Father, in your throne, Lord Father. We ask, Lord Father, before we go into anything, Lord Father, we ask for forgiveness. Talo le tua ya fa ngalo mai o matu te mata le tua. Fa ngalo mai foi pa yo ai na o matu uma le tua matu I loa. O matu te mata masala le tua. Matu fa peatu le tua te mata vea ia te fua no sa tono le tua. E manga lo ai o matu se no matu me ama le tua. Au matu mala watu lo wafi o Father, I pray. It's a prayer of comfort, my Father. Fa loto te le ina fa na o nungu le tua te ma. Father, we lift up the kids and the grandkids, my Father. Father, we lift up their hand of protection over them, my Father. Father, let this time be a time of grieving, my Father, of their loss of their father, my Father. But we pray. Father, I ask that you may bless all the kids and the grandkids, Lord Father. Father, wherever the desire, Lord Father, Father, we ask that you may comfort them in this time, Lord Father. Father, we have put your aina away for more than winner, lay yaso, let two up. Malama, my mind, let two at the bar, matu katabo, yayoman, we are yatina, Father, I pray for comfort of every single one of us, numerous family, friends, my Father, that came here, my Father. Father, we ask that you may bless them, my Father. Father, we are yatina, too. Father, we ask for a special blessing, my Father, for the man of this house, my Father. For allowing us to host this service here, my Father. Father, I pray, my Father, that you may bless the man of this house and the church, my Father, for allowing us to use this place, my Father. And Father, we ask, my Father, take mud muri la matu sauni. And Father, we lo wai lo upu le tuat tama. Amale le lo au na la va amai lo upu le tuat tama. Father, we are le tuat tama. Ye lo fa la mana le tuat tama. Ye la. Yai lo lu e lo mama se tasi mo le faro lo mo lo mo lo e tu te ma. Ia lo matu te talo na ne ia so ala ma tu e ma ne ia so le tu te ma. Ma tu la fa ia tu ia se o e fai o e ma tai tai. O e mo mua o e fo e te muli muli le tu te ma. A ma e a ne ia o nanga le tu te ma. Ia e tu e fo ia ia se o e le di inga le tu te ma. Fa ma nui a mai o e ma tai ina ne sa minga se ia o e te e fai minga e. To Maui and to oil the eating, I follow them. Amen, amen. Dr. Yatri, so I'll go for it, like the wing of the world tour. I know for it, the Nalo there tour. We are so blessed to hear the word of God this morning. Amen. Who knows, we may go out that door, something happened. You never get the opportunity to hear the word of God. Be reading to you, because I know some of us
always put the Bible on a shelf and let it just read the Bible instead of you. Praise the Lord. But the opportunity that we have today to listen to the Word of God, we are blessed. Praise the Lord. The title is Wona Leona Molieta Toto Sama. Bring prayer of comfort. We should lift our heart and be glad and joy that we have these celebrations with Brother Luke. Just keep that joy in our heart and continue believing that He always going to be here with us. Praise the Lord. Amen. Hallelujah. Take me on the time to go over the program. Before I call up the grandchildren and their program, that's how Stanley guys looking sleepy right now. Come on, get up. Let's all stand, Christ, and let's have that a nice song, and we can run around, jump up, dance like you always want to do. Now you get a chance to dance all you want. Praise the Lord. Because after this, we don't have no dance, just eat. Praise the Lord. Now dance for the Lord. Two.
Me and my papa used to be sleepovers a lot with me and just my cousin, Liz. And that was like my favorite thing to do with him, since that's most of what we did when we hung out with him.
After we had him, the first one is when we came to visit Papa's house and we jumped on his furniture with my mom and his
funny gems.
Papa was talkative and loving to the family, and he was a good person.
Determined and strong.
I would describe him as kind and helpful.
Very loving and sarcastic.
I'm gonna mostly miss his hugs since they were the best. I'm gonna miss spending time with him on the holidays and family trips.
Going golfing with him.
He's always making jokes with us and laughing. I love how welcoming my papa was to everyone, not just the adults, but everyone around him, including the kids.
I miss when we like to fall together with our cousins and aunties and uncles. I'm gonna miss the family events that he hosted because they were fun to go to. And I could see my cousins over there.
I miss Papa very, very much because he always FaceTimed me and he said that he would visit us.
Having get-togethers at his house with the family and having sleepovers with my cousin.
We love and miss you, Papa.
I love and miss you, Papa.
I love and miss you, Papa.
We love you, Papa!
We love you, Papa!
Lucas!
I love you, Papa. I
love you, Papa. I miss you.
My name is Kenya. He's my McDonald's.
I'm going to go to the school.
be shaken. I will not be moved. Even in the chaos, I know that you're good. You're the keeper, protector. It is you that holds us together when everything else fails us. It is you that holds us together.
Thank you. microphone, Nana.
Hi everyone, my name is Veronica Fasili and I am my dad's oldest daughter. I will be doing my dad's eulogy today. Va'amala Nu'u Fasili was born on October 23rd, 1966 in the beautiful village of Masapau, Samoa. His father, Papataya Fasili, and his mother, Utea Fasili. He is survived by his two sisters, Lomolomo, Leotanganga, and Waitafe Lernardo. He has four brothers, Lelua, Pastor Benny Kayese, who is not with us today, and Kaya Fasili. My dad was described as a hard-headed and always getting into trouble growing up. His dad was always big on going to church, and so if he didn't go to church, he would get into big trouble. I wish we could have seen how my dad grew up. Hearing the stories of my dad growing up made him the man he is today. He loved to have a good time, but always made sure to take care of his family. He was a family man, and that extended to his whole entire facility family. My dad never left anyone out. He wanted his whole family together, especially during holidays. I'll always remember my dad recording everyone when we did get-togethers and the smile he had on his face. We look forward to the day we get to see that smile again. He has six children, which is Longie to my right, me, Vina, TJ, Victoria, and Vincent. Of course, you can see he has a lot of grandchildren and one great-granddaughter. Growing up, our dad was always hard on us. He always wanted us to grow up and not depend on anyone for anything. I am proud to be his daughter. We are proud to be his kids. We will carry his legacy of love and family. We will make you proud, Dad, until we meet again.
My favorite memory with him will always be when we played pool together when I was younger after my gymnastics practices and how we would have family functions with the whole family and how we could get closer with everybody. I'm going to miss him so much, but what I'm going to miss the most about him is him being at my volleyball games. Rarely ever missing one.
Good evening, everyone. If you don't know me already, I'm walking on from my papa's eldest granddaughter with 11 beautiful grandchildren and one great-grandchild. First and foremost, thank you for being here. to honor the life of a man that could take so many roles. A father, a brother, an uncle, a boss, but my personal favorite, Papa. I've been blessed to have had 24 beautiful years with the best Papa, and I couldn't thank God enough. To know my Papa is to love him. Growing up, my Papa never hesitated to do anything for us. When Mom and Grandma said no, he always came through. As many of us as there were, he always provided. One of my favorite recent memories with him was after I gave birth in March. It was after everyone had left, and it was finally just me, baby, and Junior. And as I was falling asleep, I got a text from him saying he was looking for a party. And that was the last thing I remember before him walking in. The conversation was short because I was so exhausted. But as I was in and out of sleep, I would just wake up to him holding baby and sitting and talking to her as we slept. And honestly, I really feel like that spoke a lot about my Papa, his presence. He didn't have to say much, but he was there, and he was always happy to be there. I'm so blessed that he got to meet my girl and spend the little time that he did with her. I'm gonna miss his random calls in the middle of the night, just to check up on me, tell me how his day's going, or ask me about the girls. Holidays and family gatherings will never be the same. But as much as it hurts that he'll no longer be with us, it fills me with so much gratitude to know my Papa made it home back to Samoa before leaving us. Because the months before that, leading up, that's all he would talk about. My Papa taught me to have tough skin through everything, make it through high school, and work hard in everything you do, which is one of my favorite things about him. He always wanted the absolute best for us. He always wanted to make sure that we were taken care of. Thank you for installing us with the importance of family, to show up no matter what, for always calling when I didn't call first. And thank you for always asking how the girls and mom were. We miss you so much. But thank you for leaving us with a lifetime full of memories that we can now pass down as our family continues to grow. Please watch over us. I love you forever. I lost my phone, so I'm going off my heart. And that's something I was scared to do, but I know this is the right thing. If you don't know, my name is Tori, but my dad calls me Victoria.
That is.
He was such a great man. Ever since he passed away, life has not been the same. I miss getting in my car and calling my dad to tell him what's for dinner, or him calling me to tell me to pick up his laundry. Being the youngest girl in the family, so with that being, I was my dad's fit out girl. But my dad always treated me good, so I didn't care. But I want to talk about some of the lessons that I learned from my dad, and the things, not necessarily what he said to us, but what he did with his actions. My dad, obviously, as seeing all you hear, he was such a love person. He always taught us to love others, even though they do you wrong, to always love each other. Just, my dad was only 57 years old. That may be old to some people, but that's nothing. Life is so short. He would teach us to love, to forgive, to always show up, like my niece said, show up for each other. My dad loved everyone, but the thing is, he showed up for everyone, and I can see it here tonight.
Another lesson my dad taught us is, yes, he spoiled us, yes, he blessed us, but he also showed us how to work hard for what we have, to never, ever depend on anyone but ourselves, but we always could depend on our dad, no matter what. He was that guy. He was the guy for me. I will always be thankful for him. He's always been there for me every step of my life, regardless mistakes I make in my life. My dad did never judge me. He always loved me. He loved me unconditionally, and he loved all of us unconditionally. We stand here because of the life my dad lived. Yes, he was not a perfect person. Trust me, he was not. But through those imperfections, we are strong as a family. We learned so much from this man. He worked so hard. He worked every night, weekends, missed birthdays, holidays sometimes, but we knew at the end of the day it was for a good reason. Another lesson I learned from him also was to always love and respect your elders. Love and respect your mom and parents. My dad loved my grandma. I know that's the first person that he went to when he went to heaven, was our grandma. The way he loved her is the way I love my mom, the way I love my dad, and respect them no matter what. I don't care what my parents do or what anyone else, all my elders do, I love them regardless. And that's what my dad showed us. He didn't tell us, he showed us. He showed it for all of you guys, all you aunties and uncles. And I can tell by all the stories I've heard over these past few days, I'm so blessed to have a dad like him. No one can compare to my dad. And I'm so thankful that he got to be our dad, our grandpa. I'm gonna miss him so much. And if you don't know, I'm his favorite. But yes, I'm gonna miss that man. But I'm gonna take what he taught us, what he taught me, and carry it on to my daughters, my nieces, my nephews, everyone here. So I just want to say thank you to everyone here for showing up for us, for being with us throughout these few weeks, and also loving our dad. It's hard to share him, but I can see that he loved all of you guys and he cared for all of you guys, and I'm going to see him one day. Thank you.
Please excuse all of these children. I don't know who told them to come up here. I'm Vina. I am his middle-ish child. First, we would like to thank God for making today possible. I also learned a new word, Vapitai. Vapitai, Vapitai, Vapitai. The prayers, love, and support was felt so deeply. We want to express our thankfulness to everyone who had a hand in laying our dad to rest. My dad was a generous man. He gave and gave and gave. He was a family man. He loved his family. He loved his culture, obviously. He's proud to be a Facility. He took in families. He helped people get on their feet. He never hesitated to give to people. And that's the legacy that I hope that our family and our kids will carry on. I keep thinking, like, how can we as his kids, as his grandkids, honor him? And that's by continuing to bring our kids together, to gather them, to tell stories about their papa, to help people, to work hard for the things that we want. When I look at my siblings, I see the different qualities and characteristics from my dad, good and bad. there's a scripture that has like been ringing in my heart so heavy. 1 Thessalonians 4:13-14. And now, dear brothers and sisters, we want you to know what will happen to the believers who have died, so you will not grieve like the people who have no hope. For since we believe that Jesus died and was raised to life again, we also believe that when Jesus returns, God will bring back with him the believers who have died. That includes our dad. We truly believe that we will be reunited with our dad, and it will be such a sweet reunion. Our prayer is that God continues to strengthen each of us. We pray that God bless each of you, whether you give through your acts of service, helping us prepare, giving your money and your time. We just want to say thank you. We will not forget your generosity towards us at all. This is a new season. It's a new transition, entering a life without our dad. But we are hopeful, and we believe that one day that reunion will be so sweet. And we'll be able to meet with all of our loved ones, not just our dad, our grandma, Jeremiah, our papa. So we love all you guys, and we just extend our thank you.
Thank you, children of the Lord. We all know that you love your dad so much. You give it all you can. Makes this day a beautiful day and a wonderful event for your father. I'm sure you appreciate all you guys and what you're giving in the family. And continue. Like you said, continue the good legacy that your dad has set beyond you. Keep going forward from there. Love everyone. Love your family. Take care of your family. Nice time to hear the word of God. Take me your father, along with a few of my two. We are only made up for that to one. You have found your time to one. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
We want to hear the word of God today. Anointed minister of God is going to bring forth the word of God. Praise the Lord. Amen. Let's all stand. Sing a little chorus. To prepare our heart to listen to the word of God. Keep. Hallelujah.
Oops.
Father, in the name of Jesus,
We want to say thank you. Thank you for another opportunity that we have to hear you speaking to us, knowing and understanding. There will be a time in life that we cannot find this kind of opportunity.
There we go.
I will say, I'm a normal mama. My daughter, if I don't look more in the face, I will return again. Find them on my daughter. And let your mind love you long. Or let your fight long in the goodness. I am a boy, my daughter, all of us.
Amen.
For you will be in Jesus. Amen. Amen. Manatole ao leito so far mafua ina nei langa langa I ola uma. Ai ole ama no mo maua e fa feilo e tuai. Pa ia ma o lumo sardinga. Su mai o sume fa fe ngai nga mo lato fortuo. O tupu mata mali io. Fortuo mateus. Ai mai se le mamalo sa mo mo potopoto. Se o lofa ta lofa. Welcome you all in the house of the Lord this morning. Welcome you all in the name of Jesus, the precious name.
Amen.
The Lord is telling us to facilitate the family of the Lord. Ia ona wa auto manatu e fatanga o te la uma ia sofia fia o auto tama.
Amen.
Au ia isa amoa el tebino ia ia kuika sa amoa ia ai mawatu le malahalu. Ono o tara fia ia papatai ia ifanma ifangap. Ia sa tu uma mea na malanga ia walo ia sile tofa ia papatai ia. Faluano wasia ia nae tuana ia iloale malanga le uso ia po o le tofai a papatai. Au iai falmai na falmax tau. Au te lehi tatalo ile atua i se faamano loka. Ae no tatalo ile atua i se amanoa e taapena inu maroto. I didn't pray for healing, but I was praying for an opportunity to make right with God. The Lord telling me so that we know here, let us fire up a potato or say, Tamali in the valley. Fire tarts with one. And the teller, pay me an actor, I am a higher tattoo, no, the valley, tongue, or the tamata. You don't know, winger man, I'm young, I have a man. I have a tattoo. E faisio ma omo le loto le anga ma le loto le fa ma alo Edston ma io le ula quelle ula ula ma le cupia.
Amen.
Please media, can you put up Genesis chapter 50 verse 24 if you can, please. Ole upule, ole upule mo le fa na uma inga ia ele aso nei ole fa ma fa na ma le ama le afioma le tua o uporta mato Josefa. The otter on the Moema was a hungry, and failed a upule on the Aima, failed a upule on the Uso. But my own, what are you? I know what Dr. Popoli, and I see Yassi, my Yaya Tua.
Amen. Amen.
Le Fana Pele, my Aima. Le wahalulo tota ma, awa tote pole, e asi asi ma yale atua ya te uto.
Amen.
O falomo ya tomo ni mau, e le ese tamba kiki e le fa pia, thank God, wow. Pau ai mele e nire o po, o le koi tun in, ku marco komu, ku ulo e po o fata, mo fana yoi mo le atua.
Amen.
Amaya te o tomu, me o tala la apostolo, me falo na kaliko timo teo, koi fata mula ma.
Mindy.
I am the one who thank God, oh, I shall find you, man. Oh, no, or go to my boy's hand. Oh, look,
pulang ng orphan, tau ba? Ayaw ka to lang.
No.
Beautiful.
Amen.
Tere mana atau fi mi on? O fi fi awa waya tu fa fa la kutong malbiyas. Ngao sam mo ay lempal. Iye lili. Talo ayo no de mix ta ko sam. Iya I'll try my best. Allow my broken English to heal your broken hearts. Listen, all of us here born again Christians,
You kept the faith.
wina o e fatu tua ya kemiso Yesu. O ame o leo lama yo mai. Eke le ma hui wea. Amen. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
Kama ka wale lei. Moigo ya kea tau sinu. Kama ofi. Ile upo fako. O ma lego nguye ya nungu mai. Fai mai. E ya ila le kao. E ile kao. Esa wui mua.
Amen.
Que no le wui mua le. Ele vai ter que fazer o que você vai fazer. Não, 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 Morgando o afiar, vai ler que faz logo. Ele afiou a letra, a letra dela o seu for. Olha o colofa a letra. Olha, cai me, make one with God.
Amen.
Não é matar o que não, mano. Olha, cai 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 o que Na montanha dos Bahia, aí você fala mal, não na hora, não na hora, que lendo é bomba. Aí você abre na hora, não lê. Esse irmão vai fazer meio que em bomba. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Olá, mamá lá. Vai ver, vai ver, olha só o toquinho. Olha só o cara. Tem a mãe para lá, vou lhe dizer. Na montanha, olha o cara lá, apostolo. Fua yo baba ahí, fua ya que ia, y lo malama, y esta acá, al agua matú y nacho y le atuó, baba, y pao, I fought a good fight. Boca moe tan moema, y ia le atuó, boca moe tan moema. Ahora en algo ya está todo, el mundo fue a la mundo, don't forget.
Amen.
There's two destinations waiting for us. And once you miss heaven, guarantee you will never miss hell. E que me sia a hora da papa, ele é uma falha assim, ele é como uma forma lá de rua. Mas uma missia é ele, ou uma forma de rua também. Olha, é uma boa, é uma boa.
Amém.
Ele é como uma boa, né? I know it's a funeral service, but today you'll never come back. But if it's an opportunity we make right with God today, what a joy is that we make. Você é uma boa, uma boa. Tá te fazendo esse mal e a boa. A boa, a boa, a boa, a boa. Olha, precisa que ele erra. O feia é o teia. Olha, é sentar. Vai lá, é, mas ele vem com alguém. Ele vai falar, vai lá com os pais. What's the use of a man? Have the riches of the world. I'm a mal de hora. But Dr. Monroe wrote a book, Die Empty. Who said to my Lord, my father, my Dr. Monroe, the Gucci, but Die Empty, Oki Oki, my mouth. Follow my mouth, 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 my But cemetery is one of the richest places in the world. Hear me again. Cemetery is one of the richest places in the world. I said, Layo ye fo mai ye ma fa so ye ko ma ka ma wa. Layo ye ma kai dai o ye ma kai ma ku ma ai o ra o ma ye ku ma ku fa. Layo ye sai na u ma 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 sai ya o mo ka na lei e le u ma fa so. Le ta ma mai mo le ku ha o fo ki. Layo ma la ku ma ma. If you die tomorrow, the question is, Are you going to take those stuff with you to the grave? Or say, I'm going to make my regard and a chance to share what God has for you.
Amen.
What God planted in your heart. What God blessed you with. Share with others. Share the love of God in a practical way. Not just say, I love you, I love you, I love you. But the love has to be an action word.
Amen.
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
Fatima. That's your money. Adama, go and take that word with you. That's a study by the way. Are you ready to meet your creator? I can't answer that for you. You gotta have to answer yourself. Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you for your word.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
And whatever time you call us to come home, we are ready to come. Knowing in our heart and mind that we are made right with you. Knowing in our heart that we already say yes. Our life is lined up with your word, living according to you. Forgive us. For you being my Father. And Father, 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 Father. And all God's people say amen.
Amen.
Say amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen.
I know we will have question in our heart. Should I go? Should I accept the word? Should I receive Jesus Christ? Should I surrender to Him today? Or wait till tomorrow? Or wait till I go to my church? Or wait till I go again? It's a challenge for what you have to do. I want to look for them too. If you want a prayer, see Christ in your life, we have anointed minister over here that can lead you to Christ in the prayer today. But what a privilege and a challenge that is set before us today. It's knocking on our heart today. Give you a few minutes as we sing a song. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Let us pray. Jesus, our Lord and Savior, only you know the hearts of your people here today. Some may be shy to come forward to you, God. But in their heart, deeply in their heart, they want to surrender to you, O God.
Amen.
Hear the cry of their hearts, O God. And reach down in their heart. Heal them in your blood. In your name, Jesus Christ. Gather them in your hearts today. Comfort. Forgive all their wrongdoing and their sins. But cleanse our heart with the blood of Jesus Christ today. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Amen. 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 Praise the Lord. Sign for testimony. Our service is finished. Opportunity for us. Testimony, whoever wants to say something in your relationship with Brother Noah. I know our family had an opportunity last night, but we want to give the opportunity for those friends of Noah, minister that wants to say something about Noah, other people that wasn't there last night. This is a good opportunity for all of us. I know it says nieces and nephews. You have opportunity to come up. Open up our testimony today for anybody that wants to say anything. Nieces and nephews, make your way up there right now. As other people are waiting to say something about it.
God is good.
Amen.
All the time.
God is good.
First off, I just want to thank God for getting us all here safely to honor our uncle today. My name is Tina, and these are my sisters, Valerie and Jessica. We are Nuku's nieces, and we'll be talking on behalf of his nieces. Our uncle was a reliable and supportive male figure. He spent quality time with all his nieces, whether it be at his house, a park, or someone else's house. This man was all about family. And that is one thing him and I both had in common. We loved our family so much. The memory I personally will remember forever about him is he never left our side. The day we lost our father, he stepped in as a father figure and made sure we knew he was always there for us. That was just the kind of man he was. Our uncle's legacy of love and kindness will continue to inspire us every day. Thank you, Uncle, for your love, your wisdom, and your unwavering support. You will deeply be missed, but never forgotten. Your memory will live on in our hearts and in the lives of all those you touched. I love you.
He was our Makai, our uncle, a father figure to some, and a friend to many all in one. He was that uncle that would just show up. It didn't matter how big or small the occasion was. I reached out to many of our girl cousins, asking them what their favorite memory of uncle was. Many of them had the same thing to say about uncle, from him laughing hanging out with us nieces clowning, or the relationship he had with our spouses, or him showing up to our graduation or a church event for us and hearing him tell us he is proud of us. It meant so much to us girls. Or how he was the life of parties, the life of the party, my man. Or the dance-offs he would have with our other uncles, or dancing Soul Train with us. One of his lines that will forever stay implanted in our head is, "Big Daddy is here." After talking to my girl cousins, they all said the same thing about Uncle. When you hear Facili, you automatically think of new Facili. He was a family man, an amazing father to our cousins, and to the ones who didn't have a father, or a second dad to many of us. He was that uncle that taught us what family meant, and to always be there for family no matter what. Not many have a heart like Uncle. His heart was pure, and his heart bled Facili. There was a reason he was our Makai, and he wore that with pride. Us nieces are so fortunate to have an Uncle New.
Facili was everything to our uncle. To know him is to love him. He always tried to encourage us, the next generation, to bring the family together. Of course, like every other uncle or auntie, he had his favorites, but even if you weren't one of his faves, he never let it be known because he didn't treat anyone any differently than the next. Our Uncle New was one of a kind. He has always been that one uncle that stayed consistent, was always there for everyone and everything. His home was always open to anyone and everyone that needed a place to stay. His home was our safe place when it came to our family events, whether they were big or those small random get-togethers. He wasn't one to express emotions, but he was definitely one to show it. If he loved you, then you know it was always shown through his actions. He went above and beyond for family, no questions asked. Our uncle was one that was all about culture and represented it with so much pride and so much love. No matter what he went through or how he was feeling, he never wanted anyone to feel or to know. So whenever you seen it, it was nothing but smiles and laughter. The respect he had for the women in our family was so special. Even when he would get mad at them, he never disrespected them. He always talked about how your blessings come from the way you treat your sisters. He tried to teach us cousins to love one another as siblings. Even when we get mad at each other, he always talked about just letting things go. No matter how people did him, his heart was so pure. There was no hate. He loved on everyone he came across. There is no one like him, and our family will never be the same. Yeah. Thank you to my Uncle Newt's kids for sharing your dad with us and allowing us to have that special bond with him, for letting him be that second father figure to those that no longer have a dad. In closing, I would like to say to my aunts, uncles, cousins, and siblings, cherish each moment you have with your loved ones. Be a part of your culture, love on one another, especially when in times of trouble and in need. And let's continue to bring our family together. We are the next generation and must continue our uncle's legacy. A man of his word, someone that always put family first, treated his sisters like queens, and never judged his nieces or nephews, no matter the life they chose to live. Uncle, you are the heart of our Facili family and the last piece of what kept us together. You are what makes Facili. We love you and we are going to miss your presence, but like you always say, Big Daddy never sleeps.
Lord, John 14:1, do not let your hearts be troubled. Trust and believe in God, believe also in me. Ecclesiastes 3:1, there is a time for everything, a season for a season for every activity under the heavens. Good morning, families and friends. My name is Tim Matingano. I am Papa Taya New Facility's older sister's son. I am also his favorite nephew. Baumala New Facility was a father, a grandfather, uncle, great uncle, and most of all, he was the man that held down our Facility side of family. Whether it was a party, celebration, funeral, wedding, graduation, you name it, he was always there. He always made time for his family and planned for it, and he always expects everyone to be there and support and love one another. His first name, Ba'amala, Ba'a. Ba'a means boat. Uncle Lou always wanted to make sure everybody in his family was in the boat. If he didn't, he would call my mom, call me, or if he has someone against my mom, he'll call me. Why's your mama answering her phone? Man, I think she blocked you. She's mad at you. But through it all, he still loved his sisters. Revelation 21, verse 4. He will wipe away every tear from their eyes. There will be no more death, mourning, or crying, or pain. For the old order of things has passed away. In closing, we are all here on borrowed time. Amen? Use it wisely while you have it. It's always about timing. If it's too soon, no one understands. If it's too late, everyone's forgotten. If he has no time, one has always lost oneself. My greatest memory with Uncle Nu is that he hated, when I say hate, he hated the San Francisco 49ers. And the majority of the family are all 49ers fans. And I see why you hate them. I don't know. Bang bang, no game. But the reason why he loved the Seahawks, because his two sisters loved the Seahawks. That was the only reason why. But everybody else, bang bang, no gang, and Jesus' name, amen.
Thank you.
Thank
you.
Hey family, so I didn't write anything, bear with me. My name is Irene. I am Uncle Newton's older brother, Ray Lewis' daughter, the eldest of the four children. And I just been thinking about how people come into our lives for a reason. You know, sometimes we're born into families, and that's why they're there. Other times we work with them, friends, you know, whatever the case may be. They're not always there for the long haul, but through every season, you can learn something from each person that you cross paths with. And so I've been meditating on Uncle Nu and the influence he's had in my life. And so many of my cousins have had a deeper relationship with him, a more intimate relationship with him as a second father, and things of that nature. But in spite of all of that, he has made a great impact on my life. The things that really stood out to me are when I became a mother for the first time and my husband wanted to provide for us, he gave him the opportunity to work at his company like so many other people. And for us, that was a huge deal being a young family. And because of that opportunity, we were able to transfer to another location in California, which was a prayer of mine for many years. Now, in Revelation, it says that believers overcome the enemy by the word of their testimony and by the blood of the Lamb. And so I just want to testify how Uncle's love to open that door for us was such a blessing. Because as much as I was praying to leave, if I'm gonna keep it 100, which I always do, a lot of the reasons were because I was running. I was running away from family issues, my own personal issues. And some of you might think, well, why would you share that on a day like today? But in order to worship God, you have to worship him in spirit and truth. And there is no darkness in him. And so something that I learned, which was a really hard lesson, is that I think it's 1 John. The scripture says, and I'm paraphrasing, it says that if you say that you love God, but you do not love your brother or your sister, you are a liar and the truth is not in you. And I know that's a heavy word, but family, as much as Uncle loved all of us, I feel like it's necessary to put that out there because he's no longer with us. He's on in a better place. And if we could talk to him, he wouldn't want to come back as much as he loves each and every one of us. And so I just want you to really consider that.
Like, when we drop that casket in the grave, we should bury any hatred, any unforgiveness, because that would be his wish for us to continue on in true love for one another. And so I just ask that you would consider them. But also, I think about Uncle and I chuckle because I want to share the last memory that I have. Like I said, I live in California, but I was out here in June for my niece's graduation. And at her graduation, they asked me to do an opening prayer. And I did what I thought God wanted me to say. I didn't think it was anything special. And then I walked to the kitchen because I'm more of an introvert. So I say what I say, then I leave. And as soon as I got back there, Uncle came and found me. And he came up to me and he hugged me and he started crying. And I thought something was wrong. And I said, Uncle, are you okay? And he said, what you did for your family was really special. But I was just being obedient to God. And I'm just a regular person. I'm not a pastor or anything like that. But it's out of my love for God that I listen to his Holy Spirit. And so he and I were talking and I felt led to tell Uncle, like, Uncle, you know that God loves you. You know from the very beginning that he called you by name. And just go back to your first love. And that's a moment that I'll always cherish in my heart because I feel like it's easy to laugh with people, to have fun with people. But when it comes down to the nitty gritty and the eternal things of life, few of us have those moments with people and we're not very transparent about it. And so I just encourage you today to just really reflect on everything that the pastors have spoken on his children, also what they share. And to my auntie and to my cousins, thank you so much for sharing him. I know it was a sacrifice. We can never really know what you guys sacrificed in sharing him, but he was a blessing to us all. And I pray that we can return that blessing to you guys. In Jesus' name.
God is good.
All the time.
All the time.
God is good.
I don't play the rules. I knew this guy like 20 years. So I better say something because he's one of those good guys. You know, we play golf. He's good. I think maybe was better, but God is good all the time.
All the time.
I'm gonna sing a song. I think all of you know it.
Yeah.
Excuse me. E que você é o seu? I'm sorry about the head. How long are the babies? Bad guys, bad boys. You don't have a bad boys in the way. You can't pass out. You know what they say? God is good all the time.
God is great.
I call it longer my ear in the old kinga. If I long my ping, he's going to be money. I is some more number in the old body.
Thank you.
le ni ni nga lu ko le essa le ma me yo le me la pour les fait combi le bon pour qui ca le to a ko e le God is good.
All the time.
God is good. He always called every hour, every day. He never missed a call. And every time
my uncle calls late at night, and my dad's like, oh, man, what's this guy want now? But every time I see my uncle, I see my dad.
The second.
Okudu was like the closest brother to my dad. That's why it's for us. Looking at uncle, he's like our dad. So hard. Because the last memory with him was when our graduation and when my dad was hospitalized after that. My uncle almost didn't go to Samoa because he didn't want to leave his brother. But my dad told him to go because the trip that he was planning wanted to go. And when he went, he kept promising me and my siblings that he would visit my sister Manu, who is in Samoa taking care of our grandma. And he didn't. He didn't break that promise. He went to visit Manu. And he went to my mom's side, like it's his side. Like everybody says, our uncle's a family man. He treats everybody like his own. And uncle, before you left, you promised you'd be back. He said you were gonna go build a house in Samoa. Come back. You spoke highly of your kids. You spoke highly of your grandkids. You spoke highly of your sisters and brothers. I don't know what a Priscilla family would be without you. You kept saying, spend more time, spend time, spend time. As if you knew it was your last time, because I thank you, Uncle. Thank you so much for everything. Give it up to my siblings if they want to say anything.
God is good.
All the time.
God is good.
All the time.
All the time.
God is good.
I'm Uncle brother, John Ben Facilis, oldest son, and the handsomest nephew out of us all. Probably not the favorite like Tim, but I am the handsome. But there's a couple of things I'm going to say. There's a couple of things I want to say about my uncle. Just on behalf of my dad and the past couple of days and with my pops, one thing, like Brandon said, is that my dad does look like Uncle Nu. And when I seen Uncle Nu last night, man, I couldn't hold it in but shed a tear, because knowing that Uncle Nu was there for my dad, and like everyone has been testifying about Uncle Nu, Uncle Nu is and will ever be a facility, but will always be an amazing brother. I talked to this about my siblings, and knowing that Uncle Nu, he's the definition of being a brother. And I soon hope to be that type of role model for my siblings. No matter how far, no matter how near, no matter what things that the family is going through, Uncle Nu showed up. When we moved down to Vancouver, Uncle Nu always found a way to come and spend time with us. He came to the girls' graduation, came to spend time with my dad, and also, you know, he wanted to take me and my older brother Christian to go golfing, but I didn't want to test Tiger Woods yet. I'll probably test it next time. But one thing I love about Uncle Nu is that that dude was a golfer. I think Uncle Nu is better than Uncle Nu, me personally. But I just want to thank Uncle Nu for showing his love amongst us, amongst me and my siblings. Like Brandon said, the last person out of us, me and my siblings, was Manu. And I thank God for giving the opportunity for Uncle Nu to swing by and just be there for my baby sister. And that was his promise to us, was that he was gonna see Manu. You know. And I thank you guys for being here for Uncle Nu. You know, Uncle Nu has been an impact on all of us. for my cousins, Vince and TJ. I love you guys. I thank you guys for always being an older brother to me every time I came by. And I will forever got you guys back as you guys' brother, as your guys' dad and Uncle New, guys' brothers. I got you guys back. Jesus' name.
God is good.
All the time.
All the time.
God is good.
As you guys all know me, I'm a new, the daddy of the family, the youngest. Uncle Nuu is a big part of my life personally. Ever since I was little, he's always been my personally my favorite uncle out of everyone. Whenever I needed something or whenever I was down, he was always there to lift me up, and like, he was always there. Whatever I wanted, he was like, you want this, you want this. And he would spoil me sometimes. And when he came to Samoa, he sat me down and he talked to me. He told me that, yeah, my dad, he can see that my dad is really sick. But he said that the only reason why my dad kept going is because he knows that if he can keep going, I'll keep going. He told me that my parents, my siblings, they all love me very much, but it took me how long to realize that I have a true loving family right here. And that reason I found that out because of Uncle Nu. He showed me my real true family. And I thank him every day because he's the one that brought us closer together. He's the one that brought me closer to my siblings, my mom, my dad. And I thank him because he kept me updated on how my dad was doing. He was a really special part of me because he's helped me through a lot. So Uncle, I just want to say I love you and thank you for bringing me and my family together. Today, our siblings and I, we prepare to sing a song more for our uncle.
Time, you know, for a moment.
Somebody say amen.
Amen.
Somebody say amen.
Amen.
God is good.
All the time.
And all the time.
God is good.
I'd like to say a little testimony about this guy right here. First and foremost, I just give God all the praise and thanks to this opportunity to be able to speak on behalf of my Uncle Lou. My wife is here with me, Gina. I am the son of Kukina and Pastor Cook of Sake. I grew up with Pastor Tony is the son of Agnes, the pastor of White Center, Assembly of God. We now senior pastor is Pastor Dan Mungalay and Mabel Mungalay right now. Back in the days, I can remember him. He was like my idol. Some of y'all don't know this guy was talented. You know, I really appreciate the children, them telling stories about their father, how he was a great provider, and he was. But I just want to share some of the good things. Back in the days growing up, watching Lou, he was a musician. I don't know if some of y'all don't know, but he was a part of our praise and worship team back in the days. And he and the family, I didn't get to play with Mommy because, you know, he was special. But Lou was a bass player. How many of y'all remember that? If y'all don't remember Lou was a bass player, nobody knows it. Everybody's young. That means I'm too old. But I remember him playing the bass for the first time, and I wanted to play the bass just like him. Him and Benny was the two people that played the bass. And I remember watching them two play, and they used to argue who's going to play him each Sunday. And I'm like, oh, wow, there's a competition. Who's going to play Sunday? And the way I like him playing the bass, he plays it funky, and he likes to play the bass like a bass. It's supposed to sound like a boom, boom, boom. And I became a good bass player watching him grow up, watching him grow up as he teaches me how to play. A lot of things I've learned from Dude, I shared it with the kids, my work ethics. If y'all know who all in here, you know, don't be a liar. Who all used to work at Ball Foster? Raise your hand if y'all worked at Ball Foster. Yes, all the kids, everybody. Dude was, that was my boss at Ball Foster. And I remember getting hired and he told me, Sonny, when you come work for me, you better bust your butt. You better not be slacking. You better not be slumping. I don't want to hear nothing about you. He pushed me to the edge where sometimes, I don't know if you remember the line where the boxes come and you gotta stack the boxes by yourself, wrap the box by yourself, and then you gotta tie the string. And there's a conveyor that goes all the way up to there and it keeps coming and keeps coming for like 5 hours, nonstop. And I remember one time, I got stuck and the thing was keep coming and it had to stop the machine and here comes my uncle. Tony, what did I tell you? And I was like, man, I don't even go. Let's go, let's go. And that day he motivated me and he was like, you gotta push. Here's the funny thing about this. He's telling me every time I do mistakes, every day that I'm, you know, he'll say, hey, come on. You can't do that, get that. But I see MT Tonga, Tina, and all of them, they're all slacking. They got this machine where the bottles come. Some of y'all have it because y'all know. Here's this machine where the bottle comes, and you're supposed to watch for crack. Here's that stoma. And I'm like, you ain't gonna say nothing to her. She said, no, she's like, boy, we'll go to your name. But I'm telling you, I'm being honest today about this. I became a professional at my job because of him. He pushed me to strive to be a better foreman, to be a better supervisor, just to be a better laborer. I learned a lot from this guy. He didn't give up on me once. Another thing about Lou, I know everybody say, you know, the kids, all the facilities, they say that they're bad, you know, they're the favorite nephew, yeah, whatever. He calls me all the, I'm the favorite nephew. He just don't tell everybody because, you know, we talk story. Lou was like a brother to me. Everywhere I go, I remember going to Azusa, he treat me like a little brother. I remember when I first got on the airplane with him and we were walking, I was so special because he bought me everything. He didn't slack nothing. But Lou was good to me. There's only one time Lou was mean to me, and I'm gonna share that today. 2001, I was working upstairs in the warehouse, and I was working on, I just got promoted upstairs to do the machines, and some of you all know the story. I never thought I'd get caught, never thought I'd get in trouble, or, you know, the law's looking for me. And here comes the law. I thought it was safe because, you know, you ain't gonna tell, he ain't gonna snitch on me, he ain't gonna tell on me. So I'm upstairs working and I got a walkie-talkie. And it was weird how he called me. Philip Kane. You don't call me Vipo, Uso, or none of that. Philip Kane. And I said, what's up? He said, come down. No warning, no nothing. I come down, and everybody knows the office. As soon as I open the office,
there's two little sitting there. And I go, what is going on? He goes, turn around. And they put me around, they cuffed me up. And I'm like, how did they find me? And I turned around, and Uncle Lou was looking at me, he goes, shaking his head. Make a long story short, I'm glad he did that. Because I needed to change my life. He was looking out for me. He has a good heart. He does. He has a good heart. I'm going to miss him. Before he went to Samoa, I was the last person. I'm almost guaranteed I was the last person that I got to talk to him before he left. The day that he got on the airplane, he was talking to my mom, Indy. And he said some stuff that I would cherish. None of my other uncles know, my mom's brothers, they don't know about this. But he said, he told my mom, I want to have a reunion here in Washington. The mom goes in the prison. He wanted to have a big party to get the family together. He told my mom, whatever you do, or when they find you work for you, what's this you want? He wanted me to be named after my mom, which I did not know. Because Uncle Bobby had another name for me. But today I'm here to tell him I'm named after you. I don't know what he wanted me for that to do that, but I honor him for me. They call me, put me in my mouth. And because of this man, because of my Uncle Bahami, Uncle Kao and all of them, I just want to say I love you. Mabuyala mama. Peace.
Mulai kuliah apa mau dipakai? Nalai pak iya lebengi. Oleh mana marul fau kuma kami. Puang ama. Lo yoyom karkom. Lo soy kuole leli. Oleh kuol kaku olor kaku malu apa-apa. Oleh kuo fau ma fang fangam. Ya iya sorngi. Kuo Maku lau fonga melingi male pada pada lofa. O pa ia o ainga. Ai mese la fia. Yesu wa pa ia la fenga lue am kofi. Su hoia a fenga e tare lang. O pa ia o ainga. O me masang. Pa kayak. O skala koko o lo wakali. O le muanganga ya sunge shon and sweet straight to the point. O umile ka kumafkan o la ka poli kemia e ka mukai ka kumafkan. Mungyele o forfole mi yasu. Malo o kau. Malo o mawa. Papukaya ke ono wakuli papukaya. Ilau kau kua fa. Kau kua fa kemali. Kau kua lin kukua. Kau kua matile fia. Kau kua matile mu. Aore. Aore singi ungame uma. Sae kau kua malialofa. Ole mefa aulo aleli. Ole lofa. Ole koe kau I lia ni kau kua ala si zakari o posi de fia mo kau koe loa. Le ngaka I kukomu a inga ku kere mai kukaulangi o oa mai masangi a hei pepele lava ni kau kua papukaya te a fai maruema le sawa.
Lord, so one of